Hello, and welcome to the Magic Makers Podcast, where we will explore the history, legends, and magic that have helped create Walt Disney's theme parks.
Ah, there you are.
Hi, I'm Shane.
And I'm Carlene, and we're here for the Magic Makers Podcast.
In this podcast, we'll delve into the Haunted Mansion. We have some audio and video clips to show you, and we'll interview Disney legend X Atencio.
So let's get started.
Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion.
The Haunted Mansion's roots can be traced back to before Disneyland was built. Many early illustrations of the Haunted Mansion show the building in various states until the final version of the mansion was to take shape. Renderings by Ken Anderson, Harper Goff, and Sam McKim are all included in the portfolio of illustrations. The original placement of the Haunted Mansion was to be off Main Street. Then an area adjacent to Frontierland was identified as a possible location until the New Orleans Square expansion was brought to the table. These renderings of a dilapidated mansion prompted Walt to comment, "We'll take care of the outside and let the ghosts take care of the inside." Walt did not want a broken-down, ramshackle plantation house detracting from the otherwise pristine look of Disneyland. Ken Anderson was assigned the task of creating a story for the Haunted Mansion. He created a story based around a sea captain who, according to local legend, had disappeared under mysterious circumstances years earlier. This early treatment of the story was intended to be a walkthrough and already included concepts of a portrait gallery. The next storyline created by Anderson revolved around the Bloodmere Manor, a plantation house that was being reconstructed at Disneyland. The storyline had construction crews thwarted at every turn by spirits that were determined to undermine these efforts. One storyline even had Walt Disney himself playing the role of tour guide live on tape. As these early concepts were being explored, you can see elements of the final attraction starting to appear. The portrait gallery, the bride in the attic, and graveyard scenes were starting to take shape. Walt recruited two more of his top artists from the studio, Rolly Crump and Yale Gracie, for the project. Although the haunted house shows up on Disneyland maps as early as 1958, the actual mansion did not take shape until the 1961 edition of New Orleans Square. The original scheduled opening for the mansion was in 1963, but this did not happen. Walt supplied another teaser for the now completed mansion exterior. A sign recruiting ghosts for the mansion was placed outside the mansion gates. The Haunted Mansion and New Orleans Square were put on hold while efforts on the 1964 World's Fair took precedence. The concepts for the Haunted Mansion show changed, as did the Imagineers assigned to the project. Ken Anderson had been assigned back to the studio when Wed began work on the World's Fair. Walt assigned artist and Imagineer Mark Davis and background artist Claude Coates to the Haunted Mansion in 1964. Mark was a veteran of the Disneyland attractions, as was evidenced by his work on the Enchanted Tiki Room and the new scenes for the Jungle Cruise. Mark would concentrate on a variety of scenes and gags for the mansion. Claude would put his efforts into creating the interior environments for the attraction. Walt brought X Atencio over from the studio to Wed in 1965 to be a scriptwriter and put him to work on the Pirates of the Caribbean. Although X had no scriptwriting experience, he proved to be a natural. Construction again stalled when Wed's attention was redirected to bringing the World's Fair shows back to Disneyland. Two other projects became a priority over the Haunted Mansion: the Pirates of the Caribbean and the redesign of Tomorrowland. The death of Walt Disney in 1966 resulted in the loss of his final say and had serious effect on the Haunted Mansion. Creative differences between Mark and Claude led to the debate over whether the Haunted Mansion should be scary or funny. Mark Davis was able to convince management that the mansion would be better served as a comedy rather than a horror show. The other debate centered around how the show should be presented. Should it be a walkthrough or a ride-through? The time-consuming debates and delays did have one positive effect. It was now 1967, and a new and unique ride system had been developed for the new attraction, Adventures Through Inner Space. The Omnimover ride system consisted of a train of swiveling clamshell-shaped pods that could spin, turn, and tilt to point the guest in any direction, focusing the rider's attention just as film directors do with their cameras. This system also solved the problem of ride capacity by allowing an endless stream of guests through the attraction at a constant rate. These ride vehicles were dubbed Doom Buggies. With the story, ride system, and characters in place, the only thing missing was the last key element, a memorable theme song to tie it all together. X Atencio, working with Buddy Baker, had been very successful in composing the theme for Pirates of the Caribbean and was given the task of creating the theme song for the Haunted Mansion. Not only did Grim Grinning Ghosts provide the musical backdrop for the Haunted Mansion's graveyard finale, but different arrangements were used throughout the attraction. Show writer X Atencio's main task was to take all of the elements provided by the host of Imagineers and combine them in a way that would make sense. After trying several approaches, X settled on a disembodied ghost host who had appeared in a number of different treatments through the years. The ghost host, voiced by veteran vocal actor Paul Frees, and scripting by X, provides continuity to the show. The Haunted Mansion opened on August 9, 1969, and rewarded Disneyland fans for their patience. It was an instant hit and remains one of the most popular attractions at Disneyland.
Welcome, foolish mortals. I welcome to the Haunted Mansion. Now step all the way in, please. There's no time to turn back now.
Ghoulies from last Halloween, awaken the spirits with your tambourine.
The grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize. And I just try to get the feeling of that these ghosts were not a menace, but they're fun-loving ghosts. You know.
As the moon climbs high over the dead oak tree, creepy creeps with eerie eyes. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
I said, Walt, would be asked, why don't you go to open Haunted Mansion? Because the building was there and everything. And we just couldn't come up with what kind of a show we'd have in there. They thought they would have a walkthrough and get a group of maybe 25, 30 people. You go into each scene and it'd be an illusion that would work out. And Yale worked out some real weird things. But he found out that this wasn't working because you couldn't get enough people through there. If you have 30 people in a room, then 30 people wait to get the next one. And we were very, very cognizant of that. Restrictions of having to walk through compared to a vehicle that kept moving you steadily through there.